What if I told you this isn't actually OS 2, but Windows 3.1? It's obsolete technology no one uses today, but I'll bring it back to life. I'm the Vintage Collector, and these are my stories. Let's put it straight, this is the IBM workplace shell for Windows 3.1. In a way, that's a similar thing to the shell technology preview shown in my last episode, which just added the Windows 95 UI to Windows NT 3.51. It is, however, absolutely not a similar thing like the OS 2 presentation manager for Windows NT that I featured last year. The OS 2 presentation manager required NT's underlying OS 2 subsystem to work and allowed you to run OS 2.1.x UI applications on Windows NT. The OS 2 workplace shell was introduced with OS 2.0, bringing an object-oriented UI to OS 2, effectively replacing the former presentation manager. And at some point, that very same OS 2 workplace shell was then ported over to Windows 3.1, but not to Windows NT. It won't add any compatibility layer to run OS 2 workplace shell applications on Windows 3.1, but just provide the same UI experience. Before Windows 95 came along, it was quite common to replace the default shell, with many vendors out in the market doing so, and even Microsoft did that at some point using the playful Bob interface. Then, Windows 95 came along and Microsoft put a hold on this practice, with the sole exception of offering the choice to use the previous Windows 3.1 interface on Windows 95 during an upgrade. But the OS 2 workplace shell was from the times before and targeted at Windows 3.1, although you can technically speaking install the workplace shell onto Windows 95.
What about Windows Me?
And even Windows Me, but you'll end up with many errors like these, eventually leaving you with a non-functional desktop. So let's just roll the workplace shell onto Windows 3.1. There have been two releases, version 1.40 and 1.51. This setup program allows you to install different localizations and fairly provides the appearance settings where I'm just going by the default. And while it is installing, one might ask the question, why did IBM even release the workplace shell for Windows? The short and simple answer, they didn't. At least not as an officially supported commercial product. The workplace shell originates from the employee-written software program, EWS for short. This was IBM's vehicle to distribute non-official products on a non-guarantees basis. While the original website is long gone, there's still a few pages out there pointing to the EWS packages. Once installed, restart Windows to have it reload into the workplace shell. Any users familiar to OS 2.x and Warp 3.0 should instantly recognize this. It replaced the program manager as a whole, even importing the former program manager groups directly into the workplace shell. It overrides the window decorations, and even the tapped interface as known from OS 2 makes an appearance, however, the window menu is still clearly recognizable as Windows 3.1. You'll also get the system setup, which is more or less equivalent to Windows Control Panel. And in fact, it just starts the regular Control Panel applets. Here you get to see again that the workplace shell obviously doesn't replace the entire UI styling, as this window as well has the Windows 3.1 UI style from the Windows controls. The command prompt group, of course, is a bit odd, as for one, we had the DOS prompt already imported via the program manager group, plus, there's only the full screen prompt. Of course, if you want to replicate the same look and feel as how it was done in OS 2 itself, you can create a new PIF file, set it to run in windowed mode, and create a new application launcher for a DOS window. Now, if you thought this is terribly complicated, then yes it is. Because the workplace shell for Windows is limited by the capabilities of Windows 3.1, hence it needs to use the program information files with the .pif extension to manage the session settings, very much in contrast to how the native OS2 workplace shell can manage those settings directly through the program launcher properties. In a previous episode, I mentioned this obscure feature of Windows 95 that it could run Windows 3.1 on top. Just for the fun of it, I went to install the workplace shell into that co-hosted Windows 3.1 inside Windows 95, and yes, it works as well. However, even although the original workplace shell is object-oriented and the Windows version did inherit the overall functionality, there are some major restrictions in its capabilities. For example, you could use the templates to create new folders on your hard drive. It would even allow you to set a long description, although that's not to be mistaken with long file names, as Windows 3.1 knows nothing about these, even when running inside Windows 95 as mentioned before. And even so, when creating multiple of those folders with long descriptions and even using some of the advanced workplace shell features, like for setting individual background colors, these would be ultimately lost so as to disappear and only the original folder remaining there. If you have Windows 3.1 installed into OS2 as so-called WinOS2, you can even install the workplace shell there and have the same user experience on the Windows desktop just inside OS2. But beware though, as this only works in a WinOS2 full screen session. You can of course create an application launcher that runs wpsshell.exe in a seamless session, but look what happens. Even though the workplace shell inside Windows starts, you'll end up with overlaid desktop artifacts, rendering both your OS2 and your WinOS2 desktop inoperable until the next reboot. Alright, bear with me, but I love to experiment and was just curious what goes and what not. And before there's yet another outcry for using a German copy of Windows, I have a reason for showing this. Because, as shown before, you can install the workplace shell using different localizations. And as it comes with a German language module, it's supposed to also work on a German copy of Windows, right? And so it does, at least to the point when you come to the system configuration, aka the control panel. Because, as opposed to running it on an English version of Windows, the German copy will not bring up the correct control panel applet in most cases, but always end up on the color scheme applet. Now, why is that? Let's take the example of the fonts applet. When inspecting the launcher properties, we see that the control.exe is invoked with the main.cpl and fonts arguments. Nowadays, it would probably be done different, but back in the day, Microsoft chose to also localize the CLI arguments for the control panel. See here from the run dialog what happens if I run control.exe with the main.cpl and Schriftarten argument, the latter being the German word for fonts. See how it launches the correct applet now? So essentially changing the arguments for all affected launchers, being it mouse becoming mouse, keyboard becoming tastatur, and so forth, makes it actually work. In the end, the workplace shell for Windows to me seems like an obscure thing. As stated by the author, it was intended to serve as an introduction to users not familiar to OS2 or to provide a consistent user interface to OS2 users running Windows application on an occasional basis. But maybe it could have been a thought as well for companies running OS2 back in the days to just have the workplace shell everywhere, whether it was Windows or OS2, in order to deal with only one style of UI for simplifying internal support. Who knows? What's your opinion on this obscure blast from the past? Let me know in the comments below. I'm the Vintage Collector, and this was my story for today. Thanks for watching, and see you again next week. Next on the Vintage Collector. As we're talking alternative shells, there's no way around the Norton desktop for Windows. Not only did it have a DOS counterpart, but a heavily stripped down as well, which was barely of any use.